现代人生活忙碌，为了节省时间和贪图方便，大部分人都会使用业者准备的保利龙饭盒打包食物。这种用后即丢的聚苯乙烯或者保利龙饭盒被指给地球制造大量的垃圾，对自然环境造成破坏，还对健康有害等等的说法。环保组织和政要人物也纷纷地呼吁民众停止使用保利龙饭盒，以自备饭盒取代。如今市面上已经可以找到以植物纤维制造可以降解的免洗饭盒，这个饭盒不但不会对环境造成污染，品质也胜过保利龙饭盒，足以取代保利龙饭盒的位置。TKH 集团旗下的特大塑胶包装 Greatpac 私人有限公司在今年4月27号推出了一系列 Jasa Eco 环保免洗餐具，包括了饭盒、碗、碟、杯和各类的刀具。 Jasa Eco 环保免洗餐具具有可以降解的功能，它是由玉米淀粉所制造，在丢弃后数个月内被自然降解掉，不会残留对地球有害的物质。
Instead of using what we call petroleum based resins, which we then convert into plastic, we use a resource which is sustainable like cornstarch.Cornstarch, we don't use the cornstarch that you can eat. We use what we call agricultural byproduct, that means waste from the process. We take that and then we convert it into our product. And as you know, corn grows every year. We minimize our impact on the environment, and actually we are helping because we are reducing the amount of waste.
使用后丢弃，这些餐具就可以在蕴含水、阳光和细菌元素的垃圾堆里被降解，减少排放二氧化碳。
If I say this spoon is compostable in 180 days, it doesn't mean after 180 days it's going to just break apart. It doesn't work like that. It needs to be in the correct environment for it to degrade. It breaks down by bacteria.And then it will convert into gases, water, and biomass. Biomass is what we use normally as fertilizer, basically.
该公司发展部经理陈真元说，他们曾经以油棕纤维和木薯淀粉来做尝试，最后却选择玉米淀粉来作为环保餐具的材料。两年前，他们和中国的武汉华丽环保科技合作，开创玉米淀粉制造免洗餐具的先锋。
We are the first.Company in Malaysia for injection molding to do biodegradable bioplastics, the first one. We are also the first company in Malaysia, in fact, only the second company in the world to have the ability to extrude the roll sheet.And the first one is PSM themselves.
这些玉米淀粉就是制作可以降解饭盒的原料，在加入聚乳酸后溶解成硬片，硬片经过滚轮进入机器里，以150到170度的高温溶解，然后印膜。经冷风一吹，饭盒的印膜就会脱落，接下来就会进行切割的工作。再取出饭盒，一个新鲜可以降解的饭盒就这样出炉了。饭盒的正面都会印上 biodegradable 的字眼，证明它是可以降解的物品。
Is the product actually safe for consumption? Definitely yes. First and foremost, the material source is natural. Therefore, there are no toxins inside. The corn that we use is non-GMO, meaning non-genetically modified.That means it is from a natural and organic source. And when we make it into our products, we wanted to make sure that it is as safe as possible for usage. We have received FDA, US FDA certification for the material. We have sent it for our own serum tests, Malaysian standard testing, and SGS to prove that there are zero heavy metals, zero toxins,And it can be used over and over because it will not also absorb other toxins from around it.
环保免洗餐具的好处包括了品质佳、实用性强、丢弃后可以天然降解、耐热与耐冷。 无添加物和防腐剂，无化学成分，防水和防油，食用可持续性的原料和低碳足迹。这系列的环保餐具虽然才在半年前推出市场售卖，价格也比其他的塑胶餐具较为昂贵，但是却得到顾客的良好反应。
We find that generally people are more positive towards an eco-friendly product, and even more so if they think it's worth their money to pay for it. For example, a packet of spoons at Tesco for plastic, 50 pieces cost 3 ringgit. But those spoons, when you use, it breaks. Use again, it breaks. That means you need to use many times. That means the quality is not so good, but people buy because it's very cheap. I sell this at 3 ringgit 50 cent. The difference is 50 cents. Yes, it's 20 pieces, not 50. However, when you use it, you feel that it is very good quality and you can use it again.
他说，以玉米淀粉制造的环保餐具都具有很强的韧性，例如这个汤匙可以承受的扭转程度很高。目前这一系列的环保餐具都在国内三间大型的霸级市场出售。该公司用了两年的时间来研究这些环保餐具，并在机械和模具方面投资了100万令吉。之后再加上100万令吉作为发展用途，并放眼新产品，在未来的5年内为投资带来回酬。
First, we have started export to the United States for this cutlery. That is only just the beginning. We have a lot of other items which we can then export and then grow the business. There is a huge growing market in Australia at the moment. Even big corporations such as KFC, Genting.They're all, and in Malaysia, we actually achieve a milestone with Kenny Rogers Roasters, who have rejected their plastic cutlery and instead have bought our bio-based cutlery instead.
他们认为环保餐具的前景非常好，虽然国人的环保意识不强，但是越来越多人注重生态友好。他们深信，在未来的2至5年内会有很大的发展潜力。槟城州政府宣布，即将在明年1月开始禁止使用宝丽龙饭盒，违规的小贩更不获得更新执照。该公司已经做好准备，为槟城的小贩们提供足够的替代饭盒。
We are very prepared to replace any polystyrene that we do supply to Penang with biodegradable lunch boxes. However, I would like to send a message to the Penang people to practice.Responsible disposal, throw it into a dustbin. The reason that Penang had a polystyrene problem in the first place is because people were not throwing it away properly. They were throwing it on the street, on the beach, into the river and the drain, and it causes floods. This, being a biodegradable container, does not magically solve the problem. People have to be responsible as well.
有赖科技的进步和市场的需求，才衍生了这个新发明。有了这个可以降解的餐具，民众就可以放心的使用，即使必须付上更高的价钱，但是能够为地球和环境出一份力，也是物有所值。不过有了这个新发明，并不意味着民众就无需负上保护环境的责任。用完餐之后可以随意的乱丢饭盒，制造更多的垃圾来破坏环境。解铃还需系铃人，地球污染的最终源头还是出在人民的行为上。如果不改变乱丢垃圾、不做垃圾分类的坏习惯，即使有再好可以降解的食物餐具，问题始终还是存在。前线视窗采访报道。